war never changes.
Okay, I'm back. I'm wearing my hazmat suit because that was eventually the storm did come in, and yeah, not fun. So let's just put all this back on. There we go. So now I'm off to go to Piper's and hit on Christine Hurrior. I don't know. Really attractive actress. Very, very attractive. Super duper attractive. I think I'm thinking the right one. Hey, Nikki. What's up? I say, Piper, you, me, some hard luck all seem to run together like acid rain down an old. Someone's gonna pay. Where to begin?
Where do you want me to start? The part where Kellogg turned out to be working for the Institute?
Oh.
Or the part where he told me they have Sean?
The Institute. Oh boy. I've been investigating these creeps for over a year now.
Uh-huh.
The Commonwealth man. Feared and hated by everyone.
I'm looking up her. See, I'm pretty sure it's Christine something. Sometimes.
They leave old synths behind, remind us that they're out there. But to this day, there's one thing nobody really knows.
Where the Institute actually is.
Well, what's Bunker Hill? We should go to Bunker Hill. I know that's something to do.
But there's one person who has to know, right? The guy who just handed them Sean.
Kellogg. Huh. Man like that would have had access. In and out.
Yeah.
Both know that angle isn't going to work.
Because he's dead. Yeah, because he's now sarcastic. Other ideas?
Yeah.
I do like that. Talk about a literal. Can be a dick, huh?
So, a murderer and a kidnapper gets his brains blown out by an avenging parent. Huh. Be a great ending if we didn't still have the biggest mystery in the Commonwealth to solve.
It's not that bad. Yep.
He wasn't going to talk, even if I had a way of bringing him in alive.
Courtney. Okay, I was wrong. It's Courtney. Who am I thinking of then?
You know, we may not need the man at all.
You're talking crazy.
Courtney Ford.
Got a fault in the old subroutines?
Look,
who am I thinking of? I'm thinking of someone else who's equally attractive.
Relive the past moments.
Nope, that's who I'm thinking of.
Here's the day they happened.
Never mind, I was thinking of her, just a different name. Don't know why.
It'll be Dr. Amari. The mind
behind Dr. Amari.
Who's this Dr. Amari?
I'll let her give you her life.
Good job, Nick.
We're gonna need a piece of Kellogg's brain. Enough gray matter to bring to Amari and find out if this is going to work.
Jesus, Nick. Gross. Seriously?
I know it's
I like that.
What choice do we have? Got no
might have all the secrets we need to know.
Actually, I think I already have something. Kellogg.
So I just ripped off.
Thing attached to his head.
Cybernetics, huh?
And trade.
Just won the lottery.
Whether we're riding this crazy brain train or not, we can't all go running across the Commonwealth. So, who's coming with you?
Oh.
I have to go to the memory den either way. If I'm going to introduce you to Amari. If you want to head there together, just.
I'll head out with Piper. We'll meet you there.
Sounds good. You two stay out of trouble.
Sanctuary Hills, I guess.
Don't worry.
Yeah.
We're gonna get you a boy back.
Indeed.
A few more steps.
And by the way, at some point...
Between the Sheets, got it.
You owe me an interview.
Between the Sheets did, actually, technically. Can I tell her to take her clothes off? I actually can. There.
Sure. Take a peek.
Can I? Which? Okay, 2 versus 5 electricity. It doesn't matter. I'll get her something from mine. I'll give her something. What does she look like in this? Actually, let's see. Not bad. Not bad. Okay. I'm gonna want those back, though. I'm using those. Can I equip them? Okay, I can't equip them. I'm gonna get her some armor from my place. And then we can go on a raiding party. I wonder if I can just make her wear just the ring. Hey. Take those, take these. Well, I'm stealing it from you, so I'd hope you'd understand. I mean, it's a bobby pin. Suspenders and slacks, maybe I can wear those. Just the suspenders and slacks.
Nah.
Ain't got nothing better to do.
I'm sorry, what'd you say, little bitch? Come here. Yeah, one sec, Piper. I gotta save and then stab this bitch in the mouth. One second. I gotta kill her. She's really P-U-B-L-I-C-K public occurrences. God damn it. Like, magic public. Banana hammock. Okay, so I'm actually hurting her. That's good. How about this? I upgraded it recently. It's not showing me how much ammo I have. That's weird. There we go. Who's... Oh. So, you're on my side. Nick, why you gotta be like this, homie? Fine, Nick, you son of a bitch. You made me do this. You bastard. Oh, Piper's over there too, and she hates me. Look, she said a mean thing. Fine. there was a webcomic. And it's Skyrim based. And the guy asks, he's like, so what's, he's like, you know, that Dovahkiin seems kind of like a dick. And they're like, why? He's like, I don't know. Just something about him seems off. And it shows, like, it shows Dovahkiin there, the one guy or whatever, save. And then go on a murdering spree, killing everyone, and then load his game, and everyone's fine again. It's like, something's off. I don't know what it is. And I love that. Why does this keep happening? I don't think this is supposed to happen. In fact, I'm sure this isn't supposed to happen. Let's look at this robot dick. That's actually where the dick would go, right there. Depending on how big of a dick you want. It vibrates if you put batteries in his bum. So if you put batteries in that slot right there... You don't poop! None of us poo.
Big, loud, corrupt officials and
citizens. Ha! I like that. Talk to me again about Piper being like that, and I'll make love to her in front of you.
Officer,
heard you rescued back.
Okay.
Good work. Nonsense scared the hell out of me. Nikki, he ain't like those.
Okay, so everyone does know he's a synth, and everyone just kind of like accepts it. Good to know. Oh, she'd probably tell me, you're not allowed to do that, Mr. Dave. So I know for a fact that if these iBots are, they work for President Eden, who in Fallout 3 is a robot. I think there might be something about him in this one, though, because, I mean, that's all it's going to be. Okay, where am I going? Wait. Oh, that was Vault 114. Yeah. I saw a vault on the map over around this area or this area. I'm going to want to check that out eventually. Where the hell am I going? Okay, so I want to go over to... Okay, good neighborhood. Okay. Of course. Let's go to good neighborhood. I heard it's not nice there, so... I also think... there might be part of the mission with the dickhead there. What's what I'm looking for here? Shit. Silver Shroud. Which I'm going to do. I think I was going to play Metroid Prime again tonight, but I think I'll just play this. The Metroid Prime and Far Cry 4 will be tomorrow. Oh, well. On to bigger and better things. Alright, so Swan's in here. Let's see what Swan can do. God damn, he's still red-named. Well, he's still got the skull. So this does that much damage. Let's get a little closer. Little closer. What the hell are you? Five, okay. That was easy. Okay, Swan's still alive. Ow! Not much, but still. Bye-bye, Swan, you're dead. And that's how you kick the shit out of Swan. Woo-hoo-hoo! Jiggle it, bitch, jiggle it. So he's just a giant, scary-looking super mutant. Oof. Swan boat fragments. Nice. Increased damage after each consecutive hit on the same target. Puncturing. 72? I'll have to upgrade that to look less pieces of shitty, because that looks dumb as hell. Now I have one. Well, Swan was a bitch. She got Swan dog parts. Pretty sure he can only say Swan as well. Because that's what it sounded like he was doing, just going Swan. Swan, now there's a frame dip for ya. This game's supposed to be locked at 30 people. In other words, not going above or below. Okay, oh, cool. Meh. Courtney Ford, come on. Is this the right way? God, frame rate, man. I can... Like, that's bad. Oh, hey. What up, homie? Okay, something's going on. Oh, I took off that guy's arm with one shot. I'm the kind of guy who will never settle down. Alright, after this, I'm going to cut up the rest of the walk. After I kill this guy. Sorry, this lady. Oh, Piper, we're double teaming her. That's what I like. Alrighty, there we go. That was easy. Sharp metal right leg. Nice. Do I get a kick if I wear that? And, yeah, I think that one, I guess, as well. Okay, here we go. Plus one charisma, intelligent. That, what, really? Okay, sure. Alrighty, time to head the rest of the way there. After, you know, son of a bitch. I think this is how I get in? I don't know. Okay, 6-0. I don't know what that sound is. I just... Whatever it was, it exploded. God, that took way too long. It was like there was a wall right there, and I could have just like jumped over the wall. Alright, I know a mission where the synths get like introduced. Like fully introduced. Or at least a synth. Another synth because I saved and then I killed him in a different file. I just wander around aimlessly, seeing what I can do. Don't want to ruin anything to myself, and I end up doing a mission. Are you going to talk to me now, buddy?
Hey,
thought so.
First time in Good Neighbor? You can't go walking around without insurance.
You better back off, or you're the one who's going to need insurance.
Well, all right. We'll just say your insurance is paid up for now, okay? Someone steps through the gate the first time, they're a guest. You lay off that extortion crap. Good to see you again, Nick.
Hey!
What do you care? He ain't one of us. No love for your mayor.
He's the mayor! Look at the clothes he's wearing.
You keep letting outsiders walk all over us. One day, there'll be a new mayor. Come on, man. This is me we're talking about. Let me tell you.
He's gonna kill him. Hancock seems like a nice guy.
Now I know you had old Finn handled back there, but a mayor's got to make a point sometimes. You all right?
You killed him.
Got a good pair of eyes on you.
Good neighbors. I like that. You killed him.
Yeah, I feel
good. You stay cool, and you'll be part of the neighborhood. So long as you remember.
Oh, I wish I could be like, yeah, me, bitch. Oh, I got money out of it. I'm happy.
Hey.
Hi.
Whoever this brotherhood of steel is, I'm not buying.
You don't come in peace. If you come in peace, you don't bring weapons.
Well, hello. Everything here is guaranteed to injure, maim, or kill.
Those are breasts on a robot.
Except me. I only kill when I want to.
Partner.
I'll take a look. Sure.
Let's get you outfitted, killer.
That's awkward. Okay, let's just say they got the party starter. Does 50% more damage against humans. It's a rocket launcher. Nice. Or missile launcher. Or whatever. Like, oh my god. Drama. 13,000. Goddamn. Reflects 10% of melee damage back on attacker. Cool, cool, cool. Temporarily slows time during combat when you are at 20% higher, less health. Cool. I like that. See, I just had the thought earlier when I was looking at these things, is I wish I was able to, like, take those boosts off of it, like the unique ones, and put them onto other things, because I want to be able to, like, you know, load up one item with, like, 40 of these things and just see what I can do. They'll never do it, though, because then you'll become overpowered, and that's not how you're supposed to play our game, and blah, 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 blah. Ballistic fiber. Do I need that? Nah, I need other stuff.
Cleo.
I hope you're buying. Even a girl with an arsenal full of weapons needs to make a living.
Who? What yeah. are you? Oh, of course you are. It's just all those metal plates. You're a robot, right? A very womanly robot?
Designation Assaultron. Designed to provide security-related tasks to the modern man. Runtime conclusion. Why work for the man when you can work for yourself? New designation. K-L-E-O. Cleo. Robot enough for you, smooth talker? Now what are you buying?
Let's see what you got.
Okay. I'll buy some ammo or something. That was worth it. I got a lot of 38. I don't need any 38s. What am I low on? I think I need 10 millimeter. I think I'll buy some 10 millimeter. I don't want to buy that many. I'll buy 25, I guess. There we go. I get so much from when I actually kill some people, so I'm gonna keep it. Hey, Piper, you wanna touch my penis?
Stay free.
Oh, stay free, man. Yeah, stay free, man. What's up here? Whoop. I'm guessing it's anus here. Nailed it. Anus it was. Contingency plans. Laser shot at long range. She is too close to home for outright assault to be viable without suspicion. Oh, God. She says plans. Yeah, have a plan to kill everyone you meet. Hancock, kill bodyguard first. Strangulation while she sleeps. Then load all doses of chems in the old state house with poisons. Collect all damage possible, but loss is acceptable without too much disruption to the business. Wait until super mutant or raider attack. High explosives at key areas of the defensive perimeter. Relocation necessary afterwards, as Good Neighbor will be left vulnerable. I like her. So she's picked up digging sounds recently. Workers and guards being hired at high rates. Wait until night, sneak into hideout, dismantle lights, then kill one by one. Jesus. I like her style. Pay off one of his associates. Good help is so hard to find these days. Hold on to these days. Good choice. Good choice. A fellow working girl deserves a chance. Burn down the third rail as a warning. If she resists after that, clean shot to the head. Oh!
Did you say something about people screaming at you?
That's right. Some newcomers have never seen a
before. Neat.
Can't handle a friendly face. So you need some supplies?
What's it like?
Yeah, what is it like?
Being a ghoul.
Well, it's a lot worse when people always ask you about it all the time. But I
can't. Yeah, you can't because you chose to be a ghoul, apparently.
On the upside. I look pretty good for being over 220 years old.
Wow.
Now, were you buying anything?
Wait.
Yeah, what?
220 years old?
Okay. It's more like 270 years. But don't go blabbing that to everyone. Being a ghoul means you live a long time. You stop counting birthdays.
It's Cleo.
Do you know what it's like being that old?
Actually, I do.
Well, now you're just making fun of me. If you were as old,
I wonder if I can say, yeah, I was.
Since before the war. So let's hear it. Come on. Tell me what.
Oh, cool. I'm glad I did this.
I had a beautiful house, white picket fence, and a lawn with the greenest grass you'd ever seen. It was.
Okay.
Peaceful.
It was, wasn't it? Sorry. Last thing you want to see is an old lady tearing up. Well, you're either the most bad ghoul I've ever seen, or you're the second best bullshitter and Good Neighbor.
You didn't even laugh.
So, what do you...
Yeah, what do you... I want to know who you are.
Oh, sweetie. I was an angel. Oh,
okay.
Back then. Thought the world was sick and wouldn't give me... Oh. Then it all ended. And, well, I ended in a way, becoming a ghoul. Maybe when you get to be mine, everything starts to look like
270?
Anyway, I like your story better, whether or not it's true.
It's the truth. All of it.
You know, if you haven't already, check out the Hotel Rexford. There's another pre-war.
Okay.
Around there. Well, we should get...
That's barter.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
All the supplies, money, or violence can...
I like violence, money, and supplies. We have for junk. These cost a lot, but I'm looking for very specific ones before I buy them. These are a little too much. I wonder if we can get nuclear material on that. I need nuclear material. There, I like Cleo, so I'll buy... Or not Cleo. Well, she's like Mama Cleo or whatever from the TV commercials. Okay, I'm hidden now. What's going on up here? Hey, boobs. Mannequin boobs! I wonder if I can get a ninja costume for her. Or a hot, like, vixen costume. Oh, that'd be good. Damn it, Piper! I knew that was coming. Hey, bitch.
Hey.
Nope. She farted. I have a feeling she... Hey, you smell it? No, take a deep whiff. Ah! Ah! Yep. Hey, homie, what up? Okay, where's this place I can go to talk to the other pre-war ghoul. Set a just warehouses. Ah, here we go. Hall of Hotel Rexford. I can kill you all. I can kill everyone here. I am the Hokage of this dojo. As it has been said before in other people's playthroughs of things. I have no idea what that even means. Hokage or whatever. Hakalakadakadurka.
Are you going to hang out in the lobby all day again? Or are you actually going to go down and do some work?
Being available to the customers is work. It's not all about cooking chems, Claire.
It's not all about samples.
Okay, I thought that was the lady yelling at her, but...
Oh man, someone new. You need some jet, man? Homebrewed, reasonable prices?
Not today.
Hey, no worries.
Yeah, no, I'm good. Creeper.
Before you even start, let's skip to the point. We have rooms. One room specifically. Payment due up.
I'm looking for...
Can you tell me a bit about this hotel?
Yeah.
Oh, why do they always have... Hotel Rexford used to be a grand...
You sound like that ghoul. I didn't tell you that.
I had guests that didn't throw up all over the floor. But now the only people who come by are looking for somewhere to nurse a hangover or...
Or both. Kims.
So, still want a room?
Who owns this place?
Mr. Morawski. Oh, you should have seen him in his day. This place used to be flowing with high-end care, beautiful clients, and oh...
What happened?
Party. Now he just stews in the back office and disgraces his parents' memory. I swear, if they knew how far he's fallen, they'd die all over again. So why don't you rent a room before I get worked up?
No, I want you worked up.
This Morawski character.
Oh, why bother? He's worthless. The other big names caught him with his pants down, and now he just has this ratty hotel. That's the way Good Neighbor operates.
Unfortunate.
The strong make it to the top. Until someone stronger...
Yeah, that's life.
Now, are you buying this room or not? I have been working in this hotel for over 40 years, and this is not how I imagine spending my retirement. Now, are you done being nosy or are you getting a room?
Fine. Here's your caps.
The room is on the top floor. When you come to the hallway, it's the last one on the right.
Whoa. It's you. Didn't I just see you? I got whiplash. Oh, man. You should definitely try this.
Jesus Christ. It's just like all my friends. Hey, man. Here's some drugs.
Boss Morawski don't like to be disturbed.
I want to talk to you.
Excuse me.
Keep this cool. We won't have to tussle, got it?
Philosophically open door, okay? Get the hell out.
Hotel ain't what it used to be, but don't go shooting.
I could just go cutting it all up.
What's up, Morawski?
You want a room?
I like how I'm on name base with him.
Give her something to do besides breathing down my neck.
I can't, like, help him get his money back or something?
What? You got an itch or something? Talk to my okay. Assistant, Fred Allen.
Oh, okay. I can't... Okay, I really want to do, like, his... I have a feeling there's going to be a side quest where he's like, hey, can you, like, get some stuff for me and kill some people for fun? And I can say yes. Yes, I can. Okay. That looks dangerous. Somewhere a while ago here in the city, someone fell down... an open elevator shaft. Hey! Hey!
Excuse me.
What? No. It can't. It's you. From Sanctuary Hills, right?
Yeah, I'm from Sanctuary
Hills. It's him.
You don't remember me? I sold you that space in the vault. But then I wasn't on the list to get in. But you...
I like
perfect.
God, Colonel Campbell.
The vault had these pods that froze us in place. I only thought
my buddy.
What?
My buddy had been playing Fallout 4 as well, and he is 200 days into the game, basically.
Get to the future the hard way, living through the filth, the decay, and the bloodshed.
Sounds rough.
Look at me. I'm a ghoul.
God damn it, Colonel Campbell, you're fine.
I'm so sorry.
It's not your fault.
What happened?
You know, you're the only other person I met from before. I oh God. No Commonwealth.
Just the idea of him walking around the Commonwealth, like after the nuclear bomb, just talking to like stuff, like just random things, like, hey man, you want to buy some Fallout stuff?
Come visit.
There right now. You
I will. I come back every now and then.
Go check that out.
Okay, now get in with me. I feel like this could be like a horrible trick. Like, haha, I got you to sleep with me. Surprise! We had sex. Seems skeevy. Hey, check out that bed for a second. Okay, what's going on? Oh, your penis is out. Better put this in your mouth. Like, that's how I see this going. Abernathy Farm is under attack. Cool.
Piper.
She does not look happy that I'm talking to her. And then again, she was stuck trying to fall asleep for 12 hours or something like that, or like 13 hours.
Because you're a vault dweller? I know you're not wearing a blue jumpsuit right now, but the Pip-Boy and the fish out of water look.
Yep.
So here's the deal. I want to help you. Your life story.
All right, Courtney Ford. You gorgeous woman, you.
This time Diamond City had a little outside perspective.
Okay.
Besides, I'm already following you around. Might as well get some quotes while we're at it.
Oh, yep. Piper. I'm going to be nice to Piper because she's pretty.
Good.
In the bed?
Business. So, I know you're from a vault. How would you describe your time on the inside?
My family and I were frozen.
Well, you did, but...
Wait. They boxed you in the fridge? The whole time? Are you saying you were alive?
Okay, you're... yes.
Yes. I'm over 200 years old.
I'm sorry I bored you with my story. Just allow me to wait for you to stand up or something. There you go. This is great.
Oh my god. The man.
Yeah.
So you've seen the
She's gonna lay down again.
How does it compare to your old life?
Can you even compare the two? About here.
Just I'm sorry, this is just too funny to me. Just falls asleep, gets back up, falls asleep, gets back up.
For the last part of our interview, I'd like to do something different. I want you to make a statement to Diamond City directly. The threat of kidnapping is all but ignored in the Commonwealth. Everyone wants to pretend it just doesn't happen. What would you say to someone out there who's lost a loved one but might be too scared or too numb to look for them?
I'm sorry, am I interrupting your continual sleep animation. Oh god, this is gonna go on forever. Now get up. Please get up. Alright, I think she's asleep now. Piper? Piper, help me.
Hop in whenever you like.
Okay, there we go.
Wait, people just ignore kidnappings out here?
Yeah.
Okay.
In the Commonwealth, eventually someone is going to get taken. Maybe not someone you know.
But someone.
But someone. And people just say, well, could have been worse. Could have been killed by raider attacks or super mutants or...
Aww.
So I want my readers to hear what keeps you going.
Oh god, this is like one of those videos. Her mouth's a little open and she's sleeping.
You can only take it one day at a time.
There you go. Look at my pompadour wig.
That's all anyone can do.
We're all just doing what we have to, huh? I think my readers can relate to that.
That's quite the look, just like, yeah, mm-hmm,
That's everything. It's going to take some time to put this all together, but I think your story is going to get Diamond City plenty to talk about.
All right, you go to sleep. I'm just going to watch you go to and from sleep continuously. Okay, so are we good? Are you done being in this infinite animation now?
We should probably get going. Thanks again.
Okay.
Hey.
Where to?
I just tell her to stay there. No, just sleep. That's fine. I want to steal from this stuff anyways, and she'll not like it.
Well, if anyone could figure out a good use.
Okay, so she's doing the sleep talking thing again. It's weird. She sleep talks, man. It's not owned anymore, though. The Vault-Tec guy's gone. He's gonna be hanging out with me now. Ooh, sequin dress. Ooh, I'm gonna put that in her. Maybe while she sleeps. Can I actually, like, can I activate that spot and sleep right inside of her, basically? Just well rested, eh?
Hey.
Point the way.
Come on.
Yep.
Gotta get out of bed. Gotta get out of bed. That's my big knife. I should probably give her better weapons. I keep thinking about that. My followers need better weapons.
Sure. Take a peek.
Okay, I want you to be a classy broad who carries an alien laser pistol. No, pretty sure I just pick up that sequin dress. There we go. Boosh. Thank you, Piper. Let's go, baby girl. Wee. So I'm done here. Oh. I was wondering, I thought my AP was frozen.
Your room is
yeah, I already slept in it for like a few days. Okay, right, Morosky, can I help you with your goddamn thing, buddy? Oh.
Got a reason you're in my office?
Look, uh-huh.
I'm not mad, but my friend Stan over here. He's
okay.
Hates people who loiter.
Hey, Morosky.
Let me offer you some advice. You're always up.
Uh-huh.
This neighborhood. You feel okay. Now?
One day okay. You're a dick. I should kill you. Yeah, I don't want any of your candy. That's the thing. Oh, that's what the pedophile says. He drives by. Hi, little girl. I haven't seen you in a few days. I have some candy. I have all the candy in the world in my little van. Hi. That's what that is. That is straight up a pedophile statement right there. No, because I've never used it. I'm not a pedophile. Something like a pedophile would use it. I do want it. Okay, this is actually true. I want to get a van. I want to get an actual van. White painter's van, and have the words free candy put on the side. and I mean like, oh. Where's Hancock?
Oh, that's right. What matters? We freaks gotta stick together. And the best way to stick together is to keep an eye.
Oh, there we go.
You feel me?
Yeah, you sound like it is, Hancock.
So he's talking to the ghouls.
What out there in our big friendly commonwealth wanna drive us apart? What kind of twisted on?
Okay, this is weird. So, the thing is, the question here, and I mean, this is a big question, is can I become an institute?
Hey, we all know I got my own personal beef with that one. But stay focused. Now, I want everyone to keep the institute.
Okay.
When someone starts acting funny.
Uh-huh.
Things they don't normally do. When family starts pushing you away.
Okay. I could kill you, I could kill you, I could kill you, I could kill you, I could kill you. Wow. Cleo's the only one here who's actually, like, capable. Hey, buddy. How about him? It would take 3 hits to kill him. Batman! Bye, Hancock.
Stay free, man.
Don't you tell me what to do. You're not the boss of me. Okay. Do I want to go talk to Hancock? Nah, I want to go do some more story mission. Nope, I don't smell it. I can't smell it. I got no sense of smell. I kind of wish there was another way to say it. Like, I lived at this place. Here was my address. My wife was Nora. Like, I wish when you were talking to that lady there, the ghoul, there were so many more ways to just say it. But no, just had to be.
Well,
oh.
Well, Mr. Valentine, I thought you had forgotten about me.
May have walked out of the den, Irma, but I.
Oh, God, this is great. I love this. Irma and Amari have the exact same letters in their name. Piper, you might want to close those legs a little bit better. Piper? Hey, Piper, you might want to... Hey, Piper. Hey, what's up? I mean, hi.
Here for Amari.
And who are you?
Irma.
Whatever you and Nick are up to, I don't
okay.
to know. Just don't let the big metal softy hurt himself. All right?
All right. It's weird. Nick, you are walking way too slow. Your coat could use an upgrade. I think I'll give him some power armor someday. Just let him run around in power armor. So I get to sit in one of these?
Dr. Amari?
I take it this isn't.
Oh, wait, no. Irma and Amari. There's a one A extra A.
This one's all yours, Nick.
We need a memory dig, Amari.
That was wrong.
It's not going to be easy.
Irma.
The perp.
Amari.
Kellogg is already cold on the floor.
Are you too mad? Putting aside the fact that you're asking me to find a corpse. You don't realize that the memory simulators require intact, living brain.
She sounds Indian.
Isn't there some way to make this work?
This dead brain had inside knowledge of the Amari, the biggest scientific secret
of the universe.
Well, you need this, and so do we.
Fine, I'll take a look, but no guarantees. Do you?
And some other stuff as well, but here you go.
Here's what I could find.
A little smile.
What's this? This isn't a brain. This is. Wait, that's the
hippocampus. Oh.
And this thing attached to it. a neural interface?
Those circuits look awfully familiar.
It's your own.
I'm not surprised. From what I've seen, all Institute technology has a similar...
Okay. Go on.
Go on, Doctor.
Mr. Valentine is an older generation synth. But Institute technology being what it is, the brain implant could fit him. But that's
okay.
An incredible risk to take. We're talking about wiring something to his brain.
Don't worry about me, Amari. I'm well past the warranty date. Anyway.
You really think this will work?
I'll be nice to him. Idea.
We got a missing kid on the line.
He's like 50 or 30 or 15. I don't know. I actually don't know exactly how old he is.
If I start cackling like an old grizzled mercenary, pull me out, okay?
Let's see here.
Okay. Are you gonna? Here. Oh. There. Oh. Moving in. Hi, Piper. How are you? Yeah, you like that, don't you, girl? Oh, she was actually in the way. Don't take off his hat. Okay, in his shoulder. That's good. Mr. Valentine, any slight change in your cognitive function?
Feeling any different? There's a lot of flashes. Static. I can't make sense of any of it, Doc.
That's what I was
afraid of. Okay.
The mnemonic impressions.
Oh.
It appears the Institute has one.
Aww. And how do I unlock it? By getting one of those pods? There you go.
Yes, the connections appear to be stable. Hopefully it'll be as simple as unplugging the implant.
Okay.
But that doesn't get around the current problem. The memory encryption
is too strong for a
single mind. But what if we use Stu? We load both you and Mr. Valentine into the memory loungers. Run your cognitive functions in parallel. He'll act as a host. While your consciousness drives through whatever memories you
need.
Any idea what I'm going to see in there?
I have no clue.
This is weird.
I have a single piece of the medial temporal lobe and not the whole brain. I doubt.
Oh my god. I hope they took advantage of this.
All right. Let's get started.
Just sit down over there and
fingers crossed.
See you on the other side.
Yeah. This is going to be awesome. I really hope they took good advantage of this in terms of like what they could actually do with this. I wonder if it'll actually take up the entire screen or just leave that as my screen I'm playing. Because in all honesty, this could be really cool.
Initiating brainwave migration between the transplant.
Or it could be horrible, I don't know.
Mnemonic activity coming from the transplant. It's degenerated. We're going to load you into the strongest.
Okay. I will. Aw.
War never changes.